الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله أما بعد السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته I start in the name of Allah, the most merciful, the most just. May His blessings be unto His Messenger, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, unto His family, and unto all of those who follow Him in righteousness till the last hour. And my brothers and sisters, I wanted to share an amazing story with you guys. And you can learn so much from the story. There is a very important and beautiful lesson that you can learn from the story. And this is the story of a man that lived in the time of the Prophet, alayhi salam, and he was actually one of the members of the tribe of the Quraysh, as far as I know, and his name was Umar ibn Al-Khattab. Now, Umar ibn Al-Khattab, he was a very harsh man, and he was a person, he was very, very strong, physically strong, and he was also quite knowledgeable. He was a literate person, and at that time, not everyone knew how to write and read. But Umar ibn Al-Khattab, he was one of those people, and Umar ibn Al-Khattab, he was a man that used to carve idols with his own hands, and he was a man that was involved with alcohol and even with women. And one day, Umar ibn al-Khattab, he was walking, and the leaders of Quraysh, they were talking amongst each other, and they were saying, you know, we're going to be giving this amount of dirhams, this amount of money to the person who is willing to kill the Prophet alayhi salam. And Umar ibn al-Khattab, you know, he had this hatred for Islam at that time, and he was a Muslim, so he was like, you know, he was like, are you being serious? So what does Umar ibn al-Khattab do? Umar ibn al-Khattab, he takes his sword, he takes the challenge, and he says, you know what, I'm gonna go and kill the Prophet alayhi salam. Imagine, wallahi, he takes his sword and he's walking, he's going, he's on his way to kill the Prophet alayhi salam. And a little incident happens while he's going to kill the Prophet alayhi salam, and think about it, why he's going to kill the greatest man that has ever lived, the greatest man that has ever walked on the face of this earth, he's on his way with his sword to kill the Prophet alayhi salam. Why? Imagine the sin that he was about to commit. Like, you know, there were different people doing different sins, you know, alcohol and whatnot, but why he's on his way to murder, to kill the Prophet alayhi salam, the greatest man that has ever walked on the face of this earth. And this incident happens with his sister, and what happens is that while he was going to kill the Prophet alayhi salam, he actually accepts Islam. And not only that, he doesn't just become Muslim, he also becomes the father-in-law of the Prophet alayhi salam. He becomes the second closest sahaba to the Prophet alayhi salam, and he becomes the second out of the four Khulafa al-Rashidun, and he becomes the first person ever to have the title of Amir al-Mu'mineen, the leader of the faithful. Think about it. Think about the blessing that Allah Azza wa Jal gave him. And not only that, there is a narration, a hadith of the Prophet alayhi salam, where the Prophet alayhi salam talks about the 10 people, and he names the 10 people who on the face of this earth, while they were walking, and there were many, and there were a few more, these 10 people especially, the names were mentioned in this narration, and these are the 10 people that were granted Jannah. They were told while they were walking on the face of this earth that they will be from the people of Jannah. And the Prophet alayhi salam, he said Umar's name, he said wa Umar fil Jannah, and Umar is from Jannah. So wallahi, look up all of the blessings that Allah gave Umar ibn al-Khattab. Now there is a lesson that I want you to learn from it. And not only this, Umar ibn al-Khattab, he's now in the books of history. Allah, go search him up. Allah has given him this huge blessing. And what you can learn from this story is that just like Allah Azza wa Jal chose Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu, imagine he was on his way to kill the Prophet alayhi salam, the best man. Allah, the best man in history, he was on his way to kill the Prophet alayhi salam. He became Muslim, and Allah gave him all of these blessings one by one, to the point. Remember, our main goal is what? Our ultimate goal, what you want to be, is Jannah, right? Allah, that's our ultimate goal. And Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu, he was told while he was living, while he was walking on the face of this earth, that he would be from the people of Jannah. So look, all of the blessings that Allah Azza wa Jal gave him. And just like Allah Azza wa Jal changed his heart, and he changed his life from the person that he was before. similarly, Allah Azza wa Jal can change my life and your life. Allah Azza wa Jal can change my heart and your heart. Wallahi, every single one of us is sinners. The hadith of the Prophet alayhi salam, he says, كُلُّ بَنِي آدَمَ خَطَّى وَخَيْرُ الْخَطَّئِينَ التَّوَّابُونَ. Every son of Adam is a sinner. Every son of Adam is a sinner. Well, except the prophets, but every son of Adam, we, in general, Wallahi, we're all sinners. I'm a sinner, you're a sinner. Every single person that's watching this is a sinner. But the best of sinners, are those who repent. Wallahi, it's a beautiful hadith. You know, so my brothers and sisters, I want you to like try to learn something from this hadith and try to implement it in your daily lives, based on Allah Ta'ala. So Wallahi, brothers and sisters, it's a beautiful, when you think about it, sometimes you're just reflecting. Wallahi, it's a powerful, you know, hadith of the Prophet alayhi salam. And you can also use this example of Umar Ibn Al-Khattab RA, and there are many more that Allah Azza wa Jal bless. And whoever Allah guides, no one can misguide. And whoever Allah misguides, no one can guide. So my brothers and sisters, Wallahi, repent to Allah Azza wa Jal, because we are all sinners. And remember, just like Allah Azza wa Jal changed Umar Ibn Al-Khattab's life, Allah Azza wa Jal can change your life and my life. It's nothing for Allah Azza wa Jal. So repent, pray, Allah. Just remember, Prophet alayhi salam said that this life is like a prison for the believer, and it's like, you know, a paradise, like Jannah for the non-believer. So remember, whenever you're affected with, you know, hardship and whatever, Allah, you know that Allah Azza wa Jal is aware of that, and Allah Azza wa Jal is testing you. So my brothers and sisters, make sure you pray and make sure you fear Allah. That's about it. Jazakumullah khairan wa aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfiru Allah li wa lakum wa lisa'il muslimina min kulli dhanb fastaghfiruhu innahu huwal ghafurur rahim.